मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश क्लास. विश यू ऑल अ वॉर्म एंड हेल्दी डे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न ग्रामर चैप्टर 12, डिटर्मिनर्स. व्हाट आर डिटर्मिनर्स? डिटर्मिनर्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दे वर्क टू क्लैरिफाई नाउन्स एंड मेक अ सेंटेंस एज प्रिसाइज एंड फोकस्ड एज पॉसिबल. Many parts of speech such as articles, demonstratives, quantifiers and possessives can act as a determiner. In this video lecture children, we are going to learn what are determiners with examples and we are going to discuss different kinds of determiners. Which are these children? Articles, possessives, demonstratives, distributives, quantifiers and interrogatives. So let's start. What are determiners? Children, determiners are words that come before nouns to clarify the meaning of noun. Example, I have a few friends. So here determiner a few is before the noun friends, which is clarifying its meaning, that is a few friends. A determiner tells us whether the noun phrase is specific or general. Example, my sister is a doctor. Here, my is specific determiner, a doctor is general determiner. Because it is specifying here sister, that is my, and here a doctor, doctor can be any. That is the reason why it is general determiner. When you refer to someone or something specific, use a specific determiner. These are the, my, your, his, her, its, our, their, whose, one's, this, that, these, those, which. When you refer to someone or something in general, use a general determiner. The following are some general determiners, children. A, any, another, other, what, some, many, more, most, a little, less, least, a few, fewer, fewest, each, every, either, neither, whatever, whichever, all, both, half, one, two, etc. Now, let us discuss types of determiners. Children, we are going to discuss six types of determiners. Articles, that is a and the, demonstratives, this, that, those, these, possessives, my, our, your, mine, his, her, theirs, quantifiers, much, many, few, little, any, all, distributives, either, neither, each, every, interrogatives, what, which, whose, etc. First, let us discuss about articles. An article is a determiner that informs of a noun. And we know, children, a, an, and the are articles. So, these are divided into two, children, that is indefinite articles and definite article. Which are indefinite articles? A and an are indefinite articles. The is the definite article. Indefinite articles a and an. A and an are indefinite articles and the abbreviated form of the adjective one. They are used to point out any person or thing. A is used before consonants and an is used before vowels. For example, a man is standing out. So you can see, children, here a is used before the word man, which is beginning with a consonant, M. Next, an old man is walking down. So here you can see, children, article an is used before the word old, which is beginning with the letter O. Both of the above examples indicate any one man and any one old man. A is used before words beginning with a consonant and those vowels that have a consonant sound. For example, a ear. So here you can see, children, it is beginning with consonant letter, that is Y. Though university is beginning with U letter, that is a vowel, but it produces consonant sound, that is U, Y, U. So it will take article A before it. Article A is used to mean one thing or one person which is countable. For example, a box, a child, a cat, etc. To show a kind, class or species. For example, a cheetah is fastest of all animals. To express a quantity or with certain numbers. Example, a dozen, quantity, children, a little help, a lot of work, etc. To show rank, position, profession, community, etc. A lawyer, that is profession. Constable, position. Muslim, community. In exclamations before nouns, for example, what a pleasant day. Now let us learn where to use an. An is used before a mute or silent H. For example, an hour, an honest girl, an honorable man. So here you can see, children, these words, though they are beginning with H, but here H is silent. It is used before an individual letter spoken with a vowel sound. For example, he is an MLA. So you can see, children, though the letter M is a consonant, but it produces the sound of a vowel, that is M, E-M. So it will take article an before it. An is used with words beginning with a vowel and having a vowel sound. For example, an orange, an egg, an aunt, and an artist. So these words, orange, egg, aunt, artist, they are beginning with the vowels O, E, A and producing the vowel sound. Remember, children, all words which begin with the vowels A, I begin with vowel sounds. So we use an. Most words which begin with the vowels E, O begin with vowel sound, so we again use an. Definite article the. It is used to refer to something which has already been mentioned. For example, a girl is standing outside. The girl is wearing a red color dress. So here you can see, children, article the is used before girl, which is already mentioned in the previous sentence also. When the singular noun represents a class, for example, the leopard is a carnivorous animal. Before an adjective which is derived from proper nouns to refer to a whole group of people or to show a quality or a class. For example, the rich, the Indians, etc. Before the superlative form of an adjective. For example, the best, the greatest, the first, the highest building, etc. to refer to objects we regard as unique. For example, the sun, the world, the universe, etc. It is used for both singular as well as plural countable nouns. The can also be used with some uncountable nouns. Like for example, the water, uncountable noun children, the business, the meeting, the station, etc. Now points to remember children, the is generally not used before proper or abstract nouns unless it is needed to identify those nouns in a particular context. For example, the Seema I know is tall identifies a particular person named Seema who is tall. It is not used before plural countable nouns if they are being referred to in general. For example, students these days are not as hardworking as their parents used to be. Not the students. Next is demonstratives. The demonstratives, this, that, these, those, show where an object or person is in relation to the speaker. This for singular and these for plural refer to an object or person near the speaker. That for singular and those for plural refer to an object or person away from the speaker. Look at the examples, children. Singular noun, this. For example, whose car is this? That is to refer nearby object. That, who lives in that house? Which refers to far away. Plural noun, these. For example, whose cars are these? Those. Example, I am selling those books. That is for far away objects. Possessive determiners. Words like my, our, your, his, her, it, and their are known as possessive determiners. They come before nouns and indicate ownership of the noun in question as their names suggest. So possessive means ownership, children. For example, my leg hurts. So whose leg has been hurt? My. Other example, she took her cake. So whose cake, children? Her. Quantifiers. A quantifier is a word or phrase which indicates a number or amount being referred to. It generally comes before noun or noun phrase. Some, many, a lot of, a few are the examples of quantifiers. Children, quantifiers can be used with both countable and uncountable nouns. For example, there are some books on the desk. So, some can be used with both countable and uncountable nouns, children. He has got only a few books. A few is used to refer countable nouns. How much money have you got? Much is used for uncountable nouns. Children, here are some quantifiers which we can use with uncountable nouns only, some which we can use with countable nouns only, and others which we can use with both countable and uncountable nouns. Which are these?
With uncountable nouns.
Much, a little, little, a bit, a great deal of, very little, a large sum of, a large quantity of, etc. With countable nouns, many, a few, few, very few, a number of, several, a large number of, a great number of, a majority of. With both uncountable and countable nouns, all, enough, more, most, less, least, no, none, a lot of, plenty of, not any, some, etc. Children, note, few, very few, mean that there is not enough of something. A few means that there is not a lot of something, but there is enough. Little, very little, mean that there is not enough of something. A little means that there is not a lot of something, but there is enough. So you can see, children, few, very few, little, very little are negatives. A few, a little are positives. Distributives. The words both, each, every, either, neither, another, other are known as distributives. They are used to refer to each element or individual of a group or class. We use each when we think of people or things seen as separate individuals. Every is used when we mean everyone that together make up the group. Each is used for two and every to mean three or more. Either is used to mean one or the other of two people or things. That means any one out of two people or things. Neither refers to not the one nor the other of two people or things. That means not any of the two. Other is used with singular uncountable nouns and plural nouns. We use the indefinite article an before other. We write it as one word, another. So you can see, children, by adding indefinite article an to the word other, which word is framed? Another. It is used with singular nouns. For example, every person here is respected. Would you like another coffee? Last is interrogatives. Interrogatives are determiners used to ask questions. They are who, which, whom, whose, what. They are used to inquire about the noun. For example, whose books are these? So you can see, children, it is inquiring about the noun books, that it belongs to whom. Children, with this we have completed the topic determiners, and I hope that you all are revising grammar topics and practicing exercises on regular basis. May God bless you all. Thank you.